In this video, we are going to know how the images formed in the plane mirror. Daily, we are seeing our faces in our home by using the plane mirror. If you are supposed to stand in front of the mirror in somewhat distance, your whole image will be appear inside of the mirror at the same distance. Can you realize that one? If you're not, we will analyze the problem, how the images are formed in a plane mirror and what are all the characteristics in a plane mirror. So it's all due to the reflection of light. The one of the phenomena of light is reflection. So the image formed in the plane mirror is in the process of reflection. And before that, we know very well laws of reflection. Incident ray, emergent ray, that is a reflected ray, and normal line. The three lines are lies in the same plane, that is a coplanar. And then second point is, the angle of incidence is equivalent to angle of reflection. By this information, by this law, we are going to find how the images are formed inside the plane mirror. Okay. And before the problem, sir, a person is standing in front of the mirror at the point of A. Okay. At the point of A. Now, this is a plane mirror. It is a partially silver, so I am going to rough on the one surface. So at the point of A, a person is standing in front of the mirror. Actually, what will happen by the law of reflection, a ray starts from A and it will be meet at the point of O. Am I right? At the point of O in a plane mirror. Instantly, I am going to draw the normal line to the O. So this is N. AO is the incident ray and OM is the normal line and drawn is perpendicular to the plane of mirror. According to the law of reflection, the angle of incidence I is equivalent to angle of reflection. So the same amount of angle the light will be reflected. So like this, I am going to mention this point as B. Okay students, so in front of the mirror I am going to fix a point of A. From this point the light is traveling towards a point O in plane mirror and it will be reflected partially in somewhat direction, some angle. So I am going to mention B. At the same time, from the point of A, a light rays travels towards a plane mirror in a straight line and hit the point of D. It will be rebounds to the same medium, so it will be returned to the same path. That is a ray of light. Okay, this all the phenomena is due to reflection. Now we want to know how the images formed in the plane mirror. So now I am going to draw the extra line. What is the extra line? I am going to extend the BO line, extended, and then AD line going to extend. At what point these two lines are intercepts, I am going to mention as the A prime. At the point of A prime, the person, it is standing in A, its images will be created at the A prime. So we want to know how distance it will be appear. From the A to D distance is a small d, that is a distance between the person and the plane mirror. At the same distance, the image will be created. So we know very well the angle of AON
angle of AON is equivalent to angle of BON. According to the laws of reflection, angle of incidence I is equal to angle of reflection R. Using this expression, I am going to find the distance between the object to the plane mirror and image to the plane mirror. Okay, let me discuss. Now, let me analyze the incident ray path and then reflected ray path. What is the incident ray path? AON. Angle of AON is equivalent to, this is the incident ray path. At the same manner, from the light source A, it travels towards the plane mirror D and it will be detailed to the same path of A. So, it creates certain angle with respect to the normal line. So, BAO, that is the angle of BAO is equivalent to AON. Am I right? This is the incident ray angle. So we find AON is the incident ray angle and then angle of BON is the reflected angle. Now I got the expression of reflected ray angle of AON is equal to DAO. And then in this case, what is the reflected area? Angle of BON. Angle of BON is equivalent to, sir, here we drawn the extended line from the reflected rays and then reflected rays. So it will be meet on the point of A prime. It creates a certain angle of triangle. So O A prime D. Am I right? Otherwise D A prime O. So angle of B A prime O. So here angle of incidence is equivalent to angle of reflection. So here angle of BAO is equal to angle of BA prime O. It is equal. So here the distance between the plane mirror and the real object from A to D is the small d. And then the image distance from the plane mirror D to A prime. So angle of DAO, the distance of contrary, so this one is AB, isn't it? And the next one, the image distance from the plane mirror, this is DA prime, which is equal. The AD distance is small d and the DA prime distance is small d. This shows the distance of the image inside the plane mirror is equivalent to the distance of the object in front of the plane mirror. Very important, but this is one of the characteristics. Sir, the distance of the image inside the plane mirror is equivalent to the distance of the object in front of the plane mirror. If you are supposed to stand in front of the plane mirror, your image will be in a depth, that is in a backside of the mirror. Exactly not in the backside, it will be the distance is moving behind. You are seeing your object is going behind. If you are supposed to stand in front of the mirror and moving backwards, your image also going backwards. This shows that AD is equal to DA. This is one of the characteristics. Okay, students. So, first characteristic is the distance of the image inside the plane mirror is equivalent to distance of the object in front of the plane mirror. First characteristic. And then second one is D equal to D prime. Second one is the plane mirror, the image is produced by the plane mirror as virtual image. Virtual image. And then erect image. Erect means straight image. And then laterally inverted. Laterally inverted. What is mean by laterally inverted? You just show your book in front of your mirror, plane mirror. All the letters are inverted. In front of your
plane mirror, your right hand shows the left hand side and left hand shows the right hand side. This is the laterally inverted. This is the second characteristics of image formation in the plane mirror. And the third one is, sir, how much of distance formed in the image is equivalent to, that much of distance is equivalent in real object. That's why we discussed d equal to d prime. The distance of the image inside of the plane mirror is equivalent to the distance of the object in front of the plane mirror. Okay, sir. If you are supposed to place the object between the two plane mirrors, if you are supposed to place the object between the two plane mirrors, how many numbers of images will be produced in somewhat angle? So, here, if you want to find the image's value, like symmetrically or antisymmetrically or unsymmetrically, the expression is n is equal to 360 divided by theta minus of 1. By using this expression, you can easily find out how many number of images produced if you are supposed to place the object in front of the two plane mirrors. For example, the theta becomes 30 degree. For example, n is equal to 360 divided by 30. That means the object is placed in between the two plane mirrors at somewhat angles, 30 degree. So I am going to simplify this equation. So 12 minus of 1 equal to, we are going to find the 11 number of images. Okay, students, this is a very important point and very important formula also. Study well.